Hello, Internet, and welcome back to more Fallout New Vegas.
And we're back. This is Mr. New Vegas, and I feel something magic in the air tonight, and I'm not just talking about the gamma radiation. I've got news for you. NCR officials at Camp McCarran were relieved when technical difficulties with its monorail line to the New Vegas Strip proved easy to fix. One anonymous official told us a serious mechanical failure would have been a disaster because of the age of the train and the scarcity of the replacement parts. Moving on. Merchants are saying that there's been little contact between traders from Nipton in recent days, causing concerns that the isolated town may be in trouble. Promotional consideration for this news program has been paid for by the Ultralux. The Ultralux. Live life in the lap of luxury. You know, sometimes the journey beats the destination. And especially if your spurs go jingle, 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 and you meet some nice gals along the way.
Okay, this fight got a lot more serious than I was expecting right at the gate. Okay, let's, I'm just gonna turn this up. It's been a while since we've been on the radio. Do you want any kind of just heal me for a few seconds? Nonsense. Okay, this is actually getting serious. Oh, goodness. Yes, cool. You holy Jesus Christ! This thing needs to calm itself. Do I have anything? I'm dead. I killed myself. No, I didn't. Interesting. Okay.
At least I found this location. Regained consciousness and made a full recovery. Now that's a delivery service you can count on. In other news, rumors persist about a super mutant refuge nestled high in the ski lodge to the northwest. If you should find it, do not, repeat, do not belittle a super mutant for taking
Stog
the money.
Stog does not want this right now.
Those were our top stories. Ladies and gentlemen, this next song goes out from me to you.
I'm getting some fucking pie tonight. Jesus, make me use all those supplies, are you kidding me? What a I feel like I need scrap electronics. So there's a workbench. Let's just take an hour. Unfortunate. Minus one intelligence and minus one agility. Psycho's still taking place. Excuse me. Surprised that is. Jeez, it was a scary fight. I just wanted to explore this cross stuff. Johnny. Oh, fuck no. Alright. That's good environmental storytelling. I will not be going down there, because I'm not ready to fight a death block. Not after almost losing a giant rat scorpion fight. Oh wow, that was easy. How many more of those are there? Johnny Guitar. Maybe there's gonna be something there, just peace sign too what obvious. If you go? What if you stay? I love you. What if you're cruel? You can be kind, I know. There was never a man like my Johnny. Like the one they call Johnny Guitar. To be honest, I just wanted to hear more of the song. I'll tune into the Black Mountain Radio in a second. It's just a good jam. I think there'd be more hollowed out rocks, but there's only the one. Oh. I need a shovel badly.
There
That's enough of this song. There's nothing else here. Understand, what's the point of this radio station? Alright, let's head over to this quest. Because that might be everything I need to fix that robot up. I need to get my bearings real quick. Where am I? Over here. Pieces of scrap metal, 2 sensor modules, and some scrap electronics. So there's 3 scrap metal, 2 sensors, three scrap metal, 2 sensors, and some scrap electronics. Scrap metal, scrap electronics. I don't have any sensor modules. I see. How many of those do I need? Two sensor modules. Alright, so I'll keep a lookout for that. Pretty hype. I got the caps, might as well get fixed up.
Feeling thirsty? I can take care of that.
There's no way she has sensor modules. Is that a shovel? Nope, not that either.
Beak.
The Gourmand is overstating the fullness of its wait list. Those who claim to have dined at the restaurant find the food appealing, but say many tables remain empty. Also in the headlines, refugees at Bitter Springs are giving startling accounts of the legate known as Lanius, who is said to be Caesar's top field commander. One refugee told us the legate took over an underperforming squad of troops by beating its commander to death in full view of everyone. The legate then ordered a tenth of his own force be killed by the other 9/10. And you thought your boss was a pain. That news was brought to you by the Tops Casino. You'll dig us, baby. We're the Tops. Ladies and gentlemen, this
are you old now? I don't see.
I already asked him these questions.
I didn't see him. Your best bet would...
Yeah, that's strange.
It's a quiet town, and... Well, if you're looking to wet your whistle, just past Chet's is the Prospector Saloon. The bartender there, Trudy, no... Other than that, there's... Well, there's a general store just up the road, run by a fella named Chet. If you're looking to wet your whistle, other than that, there...
What?
That'd be Victor. He's real...
Just up the road is a general store. Is that really... See, I thought this was just like a closed up building. Shit, man. What am I doing with my life? Wait, I have been here. Haven't I?
Howdy. You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for. Can do.
Oh my god, he has everything! What? Jesus, dude. Okay, let's... Unfortunately, no sensor modules. Boxing tape. Actually, this is a pittance. 41 caps. Just give him something. I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a good thing? Oh, did I already sell it? The room was completely
black. I hugged her and she hugged me. Another satisfied customer. It's all about quantity over quality. Trouble is, you'll be cleaning and fixing your gun a lot more than usual when you use those kind of bullets. Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines. Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easier. There's also hollow-point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor.
Oh, ain't that a kick in the head?
The leader was a New Vegas type, a typical city boy. He had a bunch of great cons with him, probably hired guns. The great cons normally stay in their own territory way up northwest, on account of them being enemies with the NCR. Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the strip. I'm afraid I don't know much myself, Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules, so I guess that makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. If Mr. House is looking after you, it's gotta be a good thing, right? They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans.
How have I never talked to this guy?
I'm
so mad at myself. When I walked in, I saw this layout. So I feel like I've been in the building before, but I've never actually spoken to him. And that's strange. However, I guess that is done now. Crazy. I sort of want to go walking. I have not been to Sloan, so let's go back to here. Let's go to Sloan. Somewhere, somehow, someone's gonna get kissed. So on guard, who knows what the fates have in store. From their vast, mysterious sky, I'll try hard, ignoring those lips I adore. But how long can anyone try? Fight, 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 fight it with all of our might. Chances are some heavenly star-spangled night. We'll find out as sure as we live. Something's gotta give.
Okay, is this guy gonna attack? This is Radio New Vegas, and I'm your host, Mr. New Vegas. And in case you're wondering if you've come to the right place, you have. Here are our top stories. The death toll continues to climb around Camp Forlorn Hope, where Legion raiding parties are still chipping away at the NCR's hold south of the dam. Moving on. NCR officials at Camp McCarran were relieved when technical difficulties with its monorail line to the New Vegas Strip proved easy to fix. One anonymous official told us a serious mechanical failure would have been...
That's better. It's a sin, my darling. So I know I said I'd go to Sloan right now, but I'll see what's over here first. It's a sin to keep this memory of you. Huh. Silence proves that you have forgotten. Interesting.
You, Prim's got some new sheriff watching over the town now.
Yeah, I know I did that, dude. You're welcome. I know you don't actually want me. Yeah.
Never gets old when something blows up.
Who's an enemy? Oh. But all of a sudden the Powder Gangers just got mad at me for something. Before attacking. Huh. So is this one over there? This is one of the prisons they were. Oh shit, yeah. How do I get in? No! I probably missed the door at the front, didn't I? Alright, we're surveying the perimeter first, you know? Is there another cat there? I'm upset with myself. Let's see what's over here. Let's kill these freaking dogs. What the fuck? I feel like the only answer to why is there a mine here is, the Powder Ganger is so fuck it, we threw a mine there. Well, that's a good reason to me. Like, ah, shit, man. Front door, please open the front door.
Tell me where can I go? East or west or north?
Look at you. Walking in here like you're one of us. Don't you know this is Powder Ganger territory? This is, or was, the big house. New California Republic Correctional Facility. Not much correcting went on here, just slave labor. One day, us prisoners decided to liberate ourselves. Killed the warden, killed the guards, took over the whole damn territory. That'll be Eddie. You can usually find him sitting in the warden's old chair up in the main building.
So the one issue with Fallout games is they want to tell you expositional dialogue with the world. But, like, this guy came, rolled up on me, like, real tough-like, and then I asked him one question, like, oh, yeah, my boss lives upstairs, he sits on this nice chair. Like, come on, dude. Stay, like, you shouldn't be telling me all this if you actually hate me.
Well, I don't know. Depends on if you can make it worth my time. 100 caps sounds right to me. All right, you can go on in. That's us. We got sent here to fix the rails and make some new ones. Of course, dynamite works pretty good against caravan guards, too. Me? I ran with the toughest gang in the hub. You've heard of the hub, right? It's, west of here, I think. Back in California.
The hub, huh?
We've got the biggest, baddest fort in the wasteland. There's water and power, and if we need grub, we just go out and steal it.
Dude, can I join the Powder Gangers? It seems like, in terms of you got shit figured out. These are all liquor bottles. Okay, yeah, I'm joining the Powder Gangers. They are my new best friends.
Didn't know anyone would willingly walk into this place. Not unless they were looking for trouble. What's your story?
Okay, I'm gonna turn this down a little more just for the talking to this guy. He asked me a question and I can't actually answer the question. That's unfortunate.
I was a sheriff, believe it or not, for a small town far to the west of here. Short version is that sometimes justice is a little slow. I helped speed it up one too many times. I'm not sorry for anything I did, but I will do the time. Fair enough trade if you ask me.
So I guess this could have been the other guy I could have put for the new sheriff in Prim.
I understand that Cook was behind it all. I kept my head down the whole time. Didn't want any part of it. I stuck around, figuring the NCR would show up and put things back the way they were. No sense in making myself look guilty, right?
Hmm. Shit. Didn't read any of that.
He went north with some of the other guys. Didn't say where. Didn't say why. All I know is he's got some kind of score to settle with the NCR. I'm not quite sure the kind of greeting NCR troopers will give an escaped con like myself. Figure it's better to stay put for now. Right now, Eddie and his boys run the place. They've got...
Everything is going to be if I take it.
Haven't seen a decent caravan come up the road in days.
I mean, other than the fact that they rob everything, I'm totally on board with these powder gangers. Maybe that's what I just gotta run for a while. Just be a thief. Fuck it.
Never gets old when something blows up.
Scrambler's crazier than usual. Watch yourself.
I want to pick that box so badly. I'm robbing criminals. Like, I feel like the karma system is a little buggy sometimes. Like, dude, calm down. Like, calm down. I'm just trying to get my money's worth for this 100 caps. This entrance fee better give me something. Not properly and paying attention to which one of those two buildings it came out of. Not really need that ammo. And there's a guy right there. So, what are we gonna rescue?
Never gets old when something blows up.
What if that guy just says that every single time something blows up? That's their mantra. Never gets old when something blows up. I like this song, bro. Songs.
Could have sworn I saw some great cons the other day.
Heard there was a new face around. I'm the doctor around here. Sort of. I was an NCR medic for 6 months, so I'm not exactly a doctor. Still, it's more medical training than any of the other guys here. It also gives me an excuse to stay out of any raiding parties. The gang can't lose its only doctor now, can it?
Yo, Hannigan, you are a G. Smart man.
Medical supplies go for a decent amount of caps in the right markets. I figured the quartermaster wouldn't notice any missing. I was wrong.
Fair enough.
Let's see. I've been a farmhand, a bouncer, a bandit, and an NCR trooper. I don't recommend any of them. The location by the highway makes it a good spot to shake down any travelers passing through. That's why Eddie and the rest are still around. Me? I like having big walls between myself and the wasteland.
This is so smart. Like, this place is a fortress.
One night, there was a big explosion from the other cell block. I had no idea what was going on, so I took cover in my bunk. When it was all over, the guards were dead and we were free. Most of the other prisoners scattered, but a few of us stuck around, obviously. Later.
Cool. Hannigan, you're all right. I like you, dude. Okay.
Hello.
Haven't seen a decent caravan come up the road in days.
Where's my buddy, Dave?
We sure showed those bastards in the NCR. Hey.
Dahl said he let somebody in. So you going to give me a reason not to kill you and throw your body back outside? This is Powder Ganger territory. My territory. Most of the guys around here understand that. One, Chavez doesn't. Chavez formed his own crew and have been hitting traitors on their own. Everybody I've sent after him either got killed or weren't able to catch him. That leaves you. What do you say? Chavez is the ringleader. Without him, his crew will fall apart, and I don't give a shit about those guys. Good. Chavez and his boys were last seen south of here. If you're lucky and he's careless, he might still be there. Why do you care? Answer, you shouldn't. I don't feel like trading life stories.
I fought the law and the law won.
It was all Cook's idea. He and his boys managed to swipe some dynamite and hide it away in their cells. The rest of us just tagged along. Cook's crew headed north while the rest of us stuck around for payback. The NCR called it a work release prison. We lucky prisoners got the privilege of fixing up the rail lines and blasting rock for new lines. They got sloppy, though. Some of us managed to hide away some dynamite, and look who's in charge now. One mean son of a bitch. Really, truly hates the NCR for some reason. And he got a lot of the other guys around to his way of thinking. He and his crew went north. I heard talk about some sort of big plan to get back at the NCR, but haven't seen them since. Yeah, get out of here.
What are you looking at? Why? It's because I mess up people so bad they don't know what part goes where when I'm done.
Oh, God. What a guy.
Not much. Just killed a bunch of people. Maybe a couple kids, too. Whatever. Dynamite. Lots and lots of dynamite. You should have seen the body parts flying everywhere. I keep an eye on my buddy Eddie. Anybody messes with him and I scramble them real good.
I bet this guy has a sick weapon.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I really want to kill him and take his weapon.
Hey.
But there's so many people here that I can't. Not at this level, that's for sure. so it just wants me to go to the trailer. That's it. Yeah, that seems simple enough. Oh shit. I didn't try, I swear. Alright, so let's get that done. Easy peasy. Is this guy gonna make me pay 100 caps the next time I come back in too? That's really unfortunate. So close. Okay, I'm missing a leg? No, he's just posted up. Okay. I thought he was missing a leg, though. So I just go over there, kill some stupid people. I just need to kill Eddie, don't I? That's even easier. And then I'm out? That's an easy quest. That's it? Are they just gonna be standing there?
Prim's got some new sheriff watching over the town now.
Really? This is it?
You just walked into the wrong camp, my friend. That's nothing. Alright, pickings were getting slim around here anyway. You got the message. You won't see me around these parts again.
I mean, I hope that I don't think that'll ever come back to haunt me that I didn't kill Chavez. This guy will be mad at me or something. Okay, that's cool. The note reads: some of the fellas further north are trying to organize. We're starting to think it's a good idea. Got to pool resources if we're going to survive. You notice the decline in travelers. If they're getting wise, so should we. Cool note. I should have just killed four of them? Whatever, that's what we got the speech check for. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered 119 more. 119
more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. What? I'm happy you cleared that up for me, but we've got another situation to worry about. There's a merchant hanging around near the prison. Something feels funny about him, and I want you to deal with him. Shake him down if he's legit, but if not, take him out. After Texas Red. Wasn't long before. Most people already know we run this territory and are usually in a hurry to get out. Not this guy. It's like he wants us to come get him.
20 men had tried to take him. 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger.
Okay, so the powder gangers, that's a very good. Nice guys. Is that you, Scrambler? Yeah, it looks like a classic Scrambler prank right there. When they walked out in the street. Classic Scrambler. That's so close. I was thinking of ending the episode there, but like, geez, that's right around the corner. Fast travel point, so. That's some easy fast travels.
And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today.
Are you kidding me? Okay. And the ranger's deadly will. Just regular ass geckos, huh? Big iron on his head. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the oh, whatever.
Oh,
that's so cool to watch the tongue just flicker after the death. Ooh, that's cool. That's cool.
Hello? Can you help me? My girl is trapped by geckos on the ridge, and I can't get to her. Please, she's going to die. Go up the path, past the broken radio tower, and go to the right. They're at the top of the trail. You... Please, hurry. She's on the ridge, past the broken radio tower. You just...
On the ridge, past the broken radio tower. Okay. I just want to get this quest in first.
Better be careful around these parts. I hear there's powder gangers around and dangerous for merchants like me. Guess I was a little too obvious. I'm actually a bounty hunter. I was hoping to bag some powder gangers if they tried to rob me. No, but there ought to be. I'm just taking the initiative, is all.
What? You're a stupid bounty hunter. You're just a stupid bounty hunter. Pay the toll.
It's about time one of you guys showed up. I've been waiting long enough. That's a good point. Sorry I tried to ambush you there.
No, I should kill you, you idiot! You stupid idiot!
You won't see me around here again. You won't see me around here again.
You stupid idiot. My god. What's that guy doing? Is there a duck in here? Oh. Oh, goodness. Okay. Ooh, that's pretty good. That's actually pretty good. Huh, that's a good little pick right there. Stupid dude. Okay, there's an airplane here. I need to check out the airplane. Nothing going on with this airplane. So past the broken Radio Town? That's so far, dude. Up the ridge past the broken radio tower? Okay, I need to go talk to that guy again. Am I missing something? It's missing up the ridge. Alright, time to use that item that I've been saving for the perfect moment. Just past the broken radio tower. Is that a broken radio tower? I mean, I don't understand. There's a lot of broken ass shit.
Please, hurry. She's on the... You just got...
I mean, that's a broken something. I really wish this was like a... What the fuck up here? I'm going to scream. I really wish that was a miscellaneous quest marker. You know, some old... concrete. She's in gecko territory. Hoping it meant that they're gonna be up here. What the hell is that? Oh. Okay. That was strange. Okay. Let's use the binoculars one more time. If not, I can't figure it out right away. I'm just gonna go back to Eddie, finish that quest up, and end this episode. I mean, that's a radio. I think that's it. Is it close to here?
To the town of our free, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him.
I mean,
have too much to say.
I'm gonna really, really, really hope it's this.
Business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip.
I mean, really hope it's this.
It was early in the morning when he rode into the town.
This is a gecko.
He came riding from the south side, slowly looking.
But I guess I got the right.
He's in
the right place.
And running came the whispers from each lip, and he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip.
Some mole rat taking a piss. Okay.
In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red.
Yeah, do the slow zoom in for me, two-shotting a baby. This game is savage sometimes. Let me climb. Please, let me climb. No! Bethesda, Obsidian, please. You don't snake me like this. Ugh.
Was in Arizona.
No, not like this, not like this. Okay, actually, why can't I come in? I feel like all the other I feel like all the other Bethesda open world games. Cheese my way up here and over it. I tried hard enough. You know what? I'm giving up. I'm just gonna finish this quest up. That person dead. They couldn't kill geckos, so you're dead. That's. Come on. How'd you even last this long in the wasteland if you couldn't kill freaking geckos? Like, seriously. Also, for whatever weird reason, I saw that guy in the. I felt like it was a trap. I feel like he was leading me to a trap. So, for all I know, I outsmarted that guy right there. And for all we know, I let an innocent woman die. Well, no, it's Schrodinger's cat of the Fallout games, right here. Did she? Whatever.
There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still.
Yo, Eddie.
I've been thinking that since you've been good to us, we can be good to you.
They
got plenty of spare powder and dynamite around. Say the word and we can give you some of it every couple days. Good. Had him figured for NCR, one of the rangers meet. Anyway, speaking of the NCR, I need you to take a walk down to Prim. The NCR has them raised hell over a breakout, and I want to find out why. They're up to something, I can feel it.
Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
We're out of it. I know the NCR has troops near Prim, so talk to the locals and find out if any of those troops are going to be coming our way.
When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his head.
Goodness, I really hoped that would be the end of the quest. Let's see. Let's make a little save.
I've wrangled and I've rambled.
852. So, all right. Well, it has been an hour for this episode. I think this is a good place as any to call it. And next time we will finish the quest. Or at least, yeah, you know what? I guarantee next time we will finish the quest. I fought the law. Thanks for watching. This has been Lemon with Fallout New Vegas. Peace.